I'm Pastor Sue. I want to thank you for worshiping with us this morning. We'd love to have you come and visit us at First Baptist Church. We're located at 190 Main Street in downtown Brattleboro. Again, thank you for being with us. God bless you all. Bye.
Knowing that you will. bless the many ministries of First Baptist Church. Amen.
Please remain standing for our hymn of preparation, Oh How I Love Jesus, number 529.
Jesus, who is my neighbor? And then Jesus answered with this parable. There was once a man who was taking care of him, told the innkeeper, and when I come back this way, I will pay you whatever else you spend on him. And then Jesus concluded, in your opinion, which one of these three acted like a neighbor toward the man attacked by the robbers? And the teacher of the law answered, the one who was kind to him. And then Jesus replied, you go then and do the same. This ends the scripture reading for this morning. What I just read to you this morning is called Unconditional Love. Can you say that? Unconditional Love. That's the love that Jesus has for us. Unconditional love is love that goes into the world and finds people who are broken. Unconditional love goes the extra mile with no hesitation. Love is exactly what Jesus Christ reveals to the world from the cross. Love goes into the world where the rubber meets the road. And Jesus is calling us, his people, to show unconditional love to others in an imperfect world. We all know that love can take many forms. Love can appear in many different ways. Love is seen in Grace's kitchen on Wednesday, the hungry and poor. Love is walking into this church Sunday morning and smelling delicious pancakes and sausage and feeding those who are hungry before church. Love is when we have opened our doors for the seventh year of welcoming the homeless into our church. You all know unconditional love. Love is shown when we enter a hospital room and visit someone who's sick. Love is sending a card to someone who is homebound, housebound, to someone who is now experiencing hospice. Love takes many forms. Love is reaching out to someone who's just lost love, or to someone who already has. Love is powerful, and Jesus is calling his people to show love to an imperfect world. Love is holding someone who's shaking from an addiction. Love is a hug, a handshake. Love is reaching out to someone who's facing their own problems. We have such a need for love in this world. We have such a need for unconditional love because it is so important. And when love becomes unconditional, it becomes inclusive. When love becomes unconditional, it becomes intimate. Love makes a dramatic impact on a dying world, and Jesus is calling his people to show unconditional love. What does it mean? Unconditional love? It means that those who need our compassion need our love. We cannot ignore a hurting world. That traveler was injured. That traveler was attacked while he was on his way to Jerusalem. And the attack left the traveler with no money, stripped with no clothing, and beaten with severe injuries. The pain of our world, the sorrow sometimes. We all know that surrounded by a great deal of pain. And everywhere we look in our society, people are plagued with pain. Some are struck with injuries or illnesses that place them in physical pain. Some are dealing with emotional pain. Others deal with mental illness. Some people are dealing with stigma and scars of addiction. Some feel pain from being homeless. Some are living in the darkness and despair of and a priest walked by, and he kept on walking. How amazing that a man who was to work for the welfare, the good of people, ignored this man in need. That priest's focus was more on the duty of religion than on devotion to God. And then came along the Levite, and he approached the man and looked at him. But he decided not to act. He decided not to do anything. And no reason is given to us in our Bible for this man's inaction. But I think it could have been a result of fear. He might have been afraid maybe the thieves were nearby and might attack him. Or other people passed by. The Levite might be waiting for the attack. Or maybe assisting this man, helping this man, was just too darn much trouble, and the Levite went on his way. We all do this, folks. Yet Jesus taught us about compassion. Jesus sets a model for compassion for us to follow. And we see brilliant examples of Christ's compassion throughout the Gospels, but none was so definite than his plea of the forgiveness of those who had crucified him. And he looked up and he said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Everywhere that Jesus went, he showed compassion for everyone, even those who rejected him. And when he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them, because they were helpless and harassed like sheep without a shepherd. Jesus showed compassion on those who needed it the most. He ate with tax collectors. He blessed prostitutes. He touched lepers to heal them. And he openly associated with sinners. He openly loved the people. And he wasn't afraid of love or to love. He wasn't afraid of rejection. And we are following the example of our Lord. We are to show mercy and compassion on those who are hurting and helpless in this world. We are to reach out to this hurting world, and one person can make a difference. Go after this morning and reach out to someone and make a difference as Christians. We must be strong in our care. This traveler needed care. And the Samaritan showed sympathy. He reached out to this man when no one else could do that. He went out of his way to help a total stranger, knowing that this might help him, but knowing that it also could be scary to the traveler. You see, this man was robbed and he was a Jew. And the Jews despised Samaritans because of their race and their religion. But this Samaritan showed love. He showed compassion. The Samaritan could have done just enough to get the man some help. However, we see the Samaritan going the extra mile for this complete stranger. He bandages the traveler's wounds and used oil and wine from his own goods to clean his wounds. The Samaritan showed great compassion and love to this wounded man. The Samaritan also showed sacrifice. He placed the traveler on his own donkey, and he sacrificed his own personal comfort to help this wounded man. The Samaritan also provided a room in the inn for this man, so that he could have a place to heal and to rest and recover from his injuries. This was complete room and board, so that all of the traveler's needs were met. This Samaritan personally cared for this man and nursed him back to a better point of health. This took a great deal of time and energy to care for the stranger. And then the Samaritan paid the innkeeper with 2 silver coins. Well, that may not sound like the promise of an additional payment if more time was required. The Samaritan did all that he could to help the injured traveler. This message is for every person here, because Jesus is telling us we need to do everything that we can to help one another. Jesus wants us to care about a dying woman. And this will take expense on our part. It will take your time. It will take sacrifice, just like the Samaritan. But effort comes when we use our people power to reach out into the community. Think about this moment. What would happen if everybody in our world, if everybody here in this church, gave 1 hour of their time per week to be involved in outreach events? 1 hour. Imagine the difference that we could make in the world. We need to care for people. We need to love others even though that is hard sometimes. And I know that too. We need to understand the needs of other people. How many of you, when you meet someone brand new, you say, "Oh hi, what's your name?" Say, Miguel and I. "Oh, I'm Pastor Suzanne Andrews." Now, you know the name I'm going to remember? Mile? How many of you do that? We all do that. I'm totally going to forget next time I see Miguel without using it. We've got to understand the needs of other people. We need to be listeners, good listeners. We also need to be there for others. And sometimes, when I've been in the hospital as a chaplain here in Bradford, and someone's with me for you, or someone has lost a loved one, or someone has been diagnosed with cancer or any other disease, sometimes the best thing that I can do as a Christian, as a pastor, is to sit with that person and not say a word. Sometimes just your presence is enough. And spiritually, we are all Christians here. So many struggle with their faith. I imagine a lot of you here struggle with their faith. We're not going to ask you to raise your hand, because we all do. So do I. And that's why God sent Jesus to this world, so that we would know that we're not alone. So that we would know that troubles come our way. We won't give up. We will be strengthened by the power and the love of God. Jesus issued a strong challenge to us this morning who heard this Bible story. And he says to him, in the story, he says, "Go and do likewise." That's what we're supposed to do. So simple. When you leave this church, reach out to others with unconditional love. With compassion, practice forgiveness, and be the best person, the best Christian that you know how to be. And you know how people know you're a Christian? So there's a song.
Oh.
Please join in our heart and hymn, Near to the Heart of God.
We will go forth with passion in our hearts when we see someone in need.